Welcome back to 10's Late News, News Live from Brisbane. Let's go straight now to Ipswich, where I'm joined by the Mayor, Paul Pisasale. Paul, the river peaked earlier this evening, but there were some fears that it could creep up even further between now and midnight. Just how bad is it there now?
You can see the river racing behind me in a rapid current there, but it's peaked now at 13.85. We're hoping and we're praying that is the final peak, but they are saying it could continue to rise until midnight into the early hours. But we're looking at the readings at the 3-mile bridge and the 1-mile bridge. They're starting to steady. So that gives me a lot of hope that 15 metres, you know, mightn't be reached. And if that does, that's a lot of properties that won't be flooded. So we're excited at the fact that, you know, 1 metre means a lot to our community. So if it gets to the 14 and stays there, I'll be a very happy person in the morning.
Along with so many others there in Ipswich, I'm sure, Paul. Now, I understand you've just returned from the evacuation centre. Can you give us a sense of just how the residents there are coping with all this?
Well, the moment you walk in, everybody wants to ask you the first question about their street and what the water's doing, because they've been displaced from their home, and you can feel the anxiety in their voice, because here they are stuck in an evacuation centre, still feeling the emotions of 2011 and being torn away from their home again. So, you know, they're asking me all the questions, and we're trying to reassure them, you know, that we're keeping an eye on their house. All they've got to do is stay safe in the evacuation centre. But there's councillors up there because they're feeling a lot of emotion, because they've just been through this in 2011. They've just got out, you know, their home back in order, and once again they look like they might be inundated with floodwaters again, and hopefully tomorrow we'll have better news for them.
So what is the pervading emotion there at the moment, Paul? Is that despair sort of taking hold, or are they clinging to some hope that it might not reach that 15 metre mark?
Well, I'm trying to give them that hope that it might, you know, but we're preparing for the worst. But, you know, I'm quietly excited that it might be better than that. But, you know, you never know with Mother Nature. It gives you many blows. It kicked us in the guts in 2011. It's giving it a little bit of belt now. But, you know, we're a strong community. We've got a lot of people out there that want to help the community, a lot of people out there ready to support. Our whole council, one of the things we're going to do is clean up the infrastructure, get people back in their homes. We just can't wait for these floodwaters to disappear and to get our city back to normality. But when you look around Australia, you know, bushfires at one end and floods at the other end, it makes you wonder why we love this country so much. It's that Australian spirit that shines through all of us.
Mother Nature's certainly serving it right up to us. Mayor Pisasale, thank you so much for your time live for us in Ipswich tonight.
Yeah, thanks for all your help.
Thank you very much. Well, here, residents and business owners have spent the day preparing for the inevitable rush of floodwaters. Earlier today, I met some of them here in Brisbane.
On the banks of the bulging Brisbane River, volunteer armies have been mobilised once again. This restaurant was destroyed in 2011, and if the predictions are right, it will tonight go under again.
The restaurant's completely gutted, all of the stock is out. Wine this time has been removed, and it's all being stored off-site.
It's pretty surreal. It was 2 years almost to the day we've started work here, so here we are again. Hopefully it's not going to be as bad tonight.
Minute by minute, this river is becoming more aggressive. You might be able to see already there are huge chunks of debris floating past. The current's even been strong enough already to rip some large boats from their moorings. Now, it is expected that at some stage tonight, this entire area of the riverside walk will be submerged. Now, of course, that is going to force the already struggling and in many cases uninsured business owners here to start from scratch again.
We're so fortunate with our clientele, and our staff members have just literally come down. Most of this was meant to be a day off, and everybody's just come down and really put in a stellar effort.